Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I'll find out starting in today's game between the Wyoming Cowboys and the Alabama Crimson Tide.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Crimson Tide should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. Number one, make good passes and force the other team to play honest defense. Next, you gotta pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby. Third, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. We're gonna move it around the perimeter. And up, up, easy one.
Here's the replay.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Inside, the center with the ball. He shoots from long range. He's money with the shot. Trying to pack it inside. Fakes the jumper. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Five-second count winding down. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessel. Nice to have you along with us. A momentary look from three-point land. Three.
Shot didn't fall in, but it was a great use of the screen.
On the outside, the shooting guard takes the pass. He hits the shot. Bowen is emotionally pumped up.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
He attempts the trifecta. No. Shows patience waiting for the reset. He puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets.
High post screen, gonna use it?
He drains it.
Up and inside!
Fed the low block. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
High post screen.
Way off target. He'll regroup the offense. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Jump hook from the low post. And he missed. He keeps the dribble as they reset. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Inside, the center gets the pass, and off the mark. The elbow, they feed down to the low block. I can't believe there wasn't a whistle on that one.
Yeah, it should have been a whistle right there. I thought there was definitely an offensive charge.
On the outside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Defensively, great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
I like the idea of having a glass cleaner on your team. someone who can get those rebounds. Opportunity for 2-for-1.
Johnson pounded on his way up. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He goes to the line for the first time.
Concentrate. Got to concentrate on that free throw line.
He buries it. The center takes the feed. A little bit of a collision there, but no foul called it.
I think good call by the official. Not blowing the whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here's the offensive drop step, the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
The power forward gets the ball. There they are on the low block on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
And he scores it off the glass. Is showing little promise from the field in the first half, and Dick, you got to wonder if more of that is coming up in the second half.
Hey, do you think the coach is screaming a little bit down here in that locker room about shot selection? Coaches don't tolerate bad shot selection. He'll make sure it doesn't happen two halves in a row.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin. Over plays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Tries to turn on the defense and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. They're working around the perimeter. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Well, no call. You like that NASCAR. Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
From the post and goes the other way. Can't put it down. He's got to move the ball. For the deuce. Can't get the shot to go. Working it around the perimeter. The fake. Goes up for two. He gets the bucket to fall. He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Guns up the deep one. Scorches the net. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The center handles the feed. They'll work it around the arc. There's the fake. Tries for two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Bad he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
Dick, everything we could have asked for. Close game in the first half. Still close here in the second half. And this is NCAA basketball.
Hey, Brad, I think this is going right to the finish line with the last possession. Whoever gets the ball last, I think, is going to win this baby. I mean, they're making every big shot, both these clubs.
Rivers receives the pass. He looks at the hoop. For the bucket.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The Cowboys have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire. Up and inside. Wow, look at him rotate over.
Swanson receives the ball. Gave it up. The shooting guard gets the ball. Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. Play about ready to resume. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
He tries the three ball.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
That's a matter of clock management, isn't it?
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession air timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
No rebounding that. Second one, good. They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
The kick out. Moving it around the perimeter. picks off the pass. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. He goes to the line for the first time. Sinks it. No doubt about it.
This is a very important possession. They got to score to stay alive.
Seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
He takes the three. Off the rim and no good.
A little shake and bacon to use that high post screen.
Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going to get to that final Monday night game.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Crimson Tide is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.